Yeah. Now, she wowed us with her incredible creativity, craftiness, and her ability to think outside the box.
We have adored watching Denise on Making It Australia. And we're going to see her in action this morning. She joins us now from Perth with a great idea for a snuggly snake pillow. Denise, it's great to see you this morning. We've got a finished example here with us, but how do you start it? Where do you start with a pillow like this?
Well, good morning. First off, you've obviously got the daddy snake. And now I've got the mummy snake. And guess what? There's a baby snake.
Oh, sweet.
So for me to start off is what I would do is just have fun and be creative and, you know, go and select some fabrics. But, you know, first thing you need to do is go to Spotlight, go to their website, because that's where you can download every single instruction and all the equipment you need, because I can't show you all that just in this time slot. So I like to speed things up, so I always cut a paper template. Then I use my so-called pizza cutter, and then I like to cut my strips of fabric really quickly. So, you know, it makes things a lot faster. And then it's a matter of just stitching them all together and you have this one full blanket of different strips of fabric. And you know what? You can be creative and you can get the kids to use these spray fabric onto the fabric just for them to be involved.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, once you've done that, it's a matter of just folding it over and then cutting your shape and stitching it up to the point where this is kind of what you end up with. But to leave an opening so you can put your stuff in.
Right.
So,
this is amazing. I absolutely love Making It Australia. And what I love most about it is, obviously, the family can do it all together. But just using up things that we might already have around the house.
Exactly. Yes. So if you were making this snake, why can't you dismantle or deconstruct some old clothing? What about an old blanket, you know? Maybe you've got some pillows you don't use anymore. Recycle, get into the recycling, upcycling. You know, it can be different stripes of different fabrics. So I 100% definitely, yes.
Denise, I love that you've used a zipper for the tongue and you've even managed to make the snake's tail rattle. How did you do that?
Well, you know, I tried to make it interactive as much as possible for kids and I love the idea of the tongue. So for this baby one, I've got this multicoloured one. But, you know, the tongue can be large, good, fun, crazy zippers like this. But also just stitch some fabric or ribbon together, which kind of gives it interesting look too as well. And look, I've just got a plastic container. Make sure the lid's on really, really tight and pop some beads in. Put your hand down inside the snake, pop it in there, and then just keep adding your stuffing inside, and you've got this rattly interactive snake. So just have fun. And for eyes, you've got pom-poms here, and you know, you could actually make your own eyes. Well, the kids can make their own eyes and be creative. And or you go googly eyes. So it's about pushing the boundaries and just having fun.
It is great. Like I love getting on board with these things. I didn't much when I was younger. I wish I did.
Good.
Denise, I love about you, you found yourself a single mother at 23 and you took a handyman course to be more independent. Now you run handy workshops for women starting over.
I love this.
What kind of skills do you teach there?
Well, actually, I'm doing a full circle, aren't I? Because the home handy person course for me changed my whole life. So now I'm giving back to women from domestic violence or starting over. And we're only a new sort of organisation coming together. We're all volunteers. So we're lacking funding on tools and finances and a premise. But once we get that all under control, we want to teach women everything. At the moment, it's drilling into walls so they can hang pictures, fix the gate, fix some furniture. Personally, I would love to be able to show them how to upcycle, you know, a bit of roadside furniture that they can collect, bring it into our premise and then upcycle it and then have a really beautiful piece of furniture in their home that they can be proud of. So it's about empowering women and it's about giving them independence. So I think it's something I'm really passionate about, something I'm really proud of. So we're hoping to really drive this forward further down the track. So it's with the city of Bayswater. So at the moment, anyone who's interested, We'd love to see you. Come, let us help you, teach you how to use tools and gain some confidence.
Oh, I love that, Denise. We'll make sure we put all of your details on all of our social media channels. Making It Australia airs tomorrow night at 6 p.m. on 10. Denise, thank you so much.
Yes. Thank you. So lovely talking to you, and have a really beautiful day, won't you?
You too.